Hello, welcome. In today's video, we have a special announcement. We're going to talk about XEMU, a classic Xbox emulator that hasn't been featured on this channel for quite some time. For those who are unfamiliar, XEMU was one of the main emulators that contributed to the growth of this channel. However, due to some disagreements with moderator users on Discord and a lack of significant updates, our last major video about this emulator was published in July 2022. Recently, there has been an important implementation in the emulator, the addition of save states, which they named Snapshot. Before we delve into more details about XEMU and its updates, I'd like to remind you of the importance of your support. If you enjoy receiving news about emulators and staying up to date with this content, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel to receive more videos like this.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
For quite some time now, XEMU has been lacking major updates and has remained at version 0.7 for an extended period. However, as I mentioned earlier, this emulator holds a special meaning for me. For those who are trying the emulator for the first time, I advise against relying on the compatibility list provided on the official website. The development team considers any game that advances beyond the menu as playable. Therefore, even if a game is listed as playable, I recommend downloading it and testing it for yourself. Another significant issue faced by the emulator is the excessive hardware demand when using upscaling. It will be extremely challenging to play a game at a resolution higher than 4x, even with the best available hardware. For those who may not know, the classic Xbox had the most powerful hardware of its generation, competing with major names like the PlayStation 2 and GameCube. If you compare a classic Xbox game running on XEMU with a PlayStation 2 game running on PCSX2, the graphical difference is enormous. This is because the first Microsoft console's hardware was similar to a PC of that time, allowing for impressive results. However, in terms of sales, it was surpassed by the PlayStation 2, which remains the best-selling console to this day. As for the emulators, XEMU features improved object geometry and textures in virtually all games, but we still can't talk about performance. The performance still resembles that of an emulator in the development stage. When it's complete, it will be a great alternative to PCSX2. Speaking of the new feature introduced by XEMU, previously it was possible to create save states through code lines, but now they have implemented the feature directly into the user interface. Another interesting functionality that the emulator has is the ability to access all functions by simultaneously pressing the corresponding start and select buttons. Although I'm not sure if I left any pending configuration, it is possible to load the snapshots later through the emulator's menu. Perhaps this will be improved in the future, but the option to load saved states is already present in the interface. This is a feature that should have been implemented some time ago, especially considering that RPCS3 often needs to dump more than 2 GB. It already performs this function decently. Other features that are still eagerly awaited in XEMU include widescreen hacks, which allow stretching the screen without distorting the displayed objects, the ability to dump and load texture packs, and the option to choose the API used, as most emulators for systems that prioritize 3D games use Vulkan due to its better performance. Another very important point is that most games found on the internet are in HDD-ready format, where the files have already been extracted from the disk, but the emulator only reads ISO format. Therefore, to make the games work, you need to download them and then use third-party programs to convert them to ISO format for running on the emulator. For those who have never used the emulator, it is possible to encounter difficulties in getting it to work for the first time, as it is one of the most complex emulators to set up. It requires the use of Xbox BIOS and disk images, which can be a complicated process. That concludes today's video. If you are a fan of the classic Xbox or have never tried this emulator before, I recommend giving it a test and drawing your own conclusions. Thank you all, and see you in the next video.